morning, Caleb.
Good morning.
Well, we're going to take this this here roll-along, part of the roll-along series, over to the mechanic shop and do our inspection on it. A lot of people have already seen the washing video where we washed it, kind of cleaned it up a little bit. And that's not a, you know, that wasn't really a full-on detail wash. It was just a wash so we could see what we're dealing with. So, and the AC does not work. That's one thing that needs to be fixed right away, because it's about 9:30 here this morning and already about 95 degrees. So, good old Texas heat.
Super humid.
Oh yeah, humidity too. One thing I can notice that the brakes, you can hear the vacuum leaking out of the booster, the brake pedals to the floor. So we know we got probably a booster issue there. Another thing, our overdrive light is flashing. Tells us that the computer has a transmission code stored in there. We'll have to dig into that and see what's going on with that. Also, brake light on, ABS light on. The brake, emergency brake, is seeing better days. The foot pedal's gone off of it, so that may have an issue with the brake light being on. Might not, but with the brake light and ABS light on, there is a code stored in the ABS module, is why that ABS light's on. And it could be a number of things, from low brake fluid to something else going on. So, another thing I've got going on is the speedometer is bouncing and no tack. So we'll have to dig into that. Could be several different things going on there. Something as simple as the plug-in for the cluster could be loose. Could be ABS sensor and multiple other things that could be going on. So we'll have to dig in to see what's going on with that. A lot of these conversion trucks, the conversion companies, when they added all their bells and whistles to them, they're not the greatest at doing quality wiring. They use a lot of Scotch locks, just simple butt connectors, nothing really sealed. So over time, you know, this truck's what, 27 years old. Over time, those connections break down, start corroding. So that can cause issues with several other things. These E4ODs have an issue with LED brake lights, third brake lights, with not having enough resistance. So, you know, the roll-along could have, wow, these brakes are bad. Roll-along could have tapped into the wrong wire. That wire is now corroded and causing ABS brake issues. There's multiple things to be going on here. So, specific things. So, you know, one thing you're going to start off with is just visual appearance. I mean, if you see body panels falling off, trim falling off, you're going to know that vehicle's either used or abused, or multiple things are going on. But, you know, OBS Ford's specifically, these light bezels like to work themselves loose, or they're broke. This particular one, something's going on with that. We're gonna have to find out what's going on. When we do an inspection on these trucks, I mean, I write down a full list of what's going on with the vehicle. So, just so I have a checklist of, as I'm fixing things, I can check off So once you start compiling information of what's going on with the vehicle, it can lead you to fix other items too that may be associated with those fixes. So anyway, let's walk around this and see what's going on. We know got some light bezel issues. Bumper seems to be tight. This light bezel's pretty tight.
Tight, yeah!
We got some issues with some different tile style mirrors that were mounted on here. Where we'll go with that, I don't know yet. When I open the door, you can see it fall. So that tells you right there, there's something going on with that. That top hinge pin. So that's one of the things we're gonna need to address. We'll get to this on the when we do the interior. This truck actually needs rear window motors for these rear doors, so the motors are actually strong, so we'll take care of that when we get to it. You know, we're just walking along, checking all these running boards for play, they're falling off. This is a thing for me, you know, making sure everything's clean inside there. We did wash all this out when we did the wash video, but if a truck's been sitting for a while, there's usually hornet's nests or wasp nests in there, so bumper's tight.
Tight, yeah!
Tailgate. In good shape. A lot of times these bushings are messy. OBS Fords like to break. These look like they're in pretty good shape. Of course, we got a mud flap that looks like it's been on fire. We'll notice that the strike bushings are missing. We'll have to address that. Mirror's okay, just needs cleaned up. Of course, the screws from the other style mirrors. What the guys want to do on that. There are a few little dents, dings here and there. I don't think it's anything paintless dent removal can take care of, so see where that goes. As far as all the IDM, this is actually all roll-along additional wiring, so who knows what's going on with that. IDM, PCM, all the connections look good, all the wiring looks good. See a lot of issues there. It does have the recall harness done already. Tell by this blue tag. Common thing with these OBS Fords. This brake control switch had power going to it continuous. They start to leak. Brake fluid's flammable. That switch would short out with the power going to it constantly and cause a fire. Seen the OBS trucks with the hoods burnt. That's what causes it, is this recall harness isn't done. So this one actually has it done, which is nice. Okay, now we're going to start the engine and check transmission fluid, things like that. But we need to have the engine running.
Kind of normal, don't freak out. 22 underneath. Oil leaks, of course. You know, you just gotta look for fresh oil type situation. 7.3s, we're checking out the front side of the oil cooler here. Make sure there's no oil or coolant leaking. Got a little weepage around the oil pan, it looks like. Probably the front cover. Probably nothing really to be freaking out about on a 7.3. It looks pretty good. I'm going to go along. Somebody's added a supplemental oil filter on this thing. I don't really care for the Fram filters. That's just a personal thing, but I don't think they're very good. Anyway, we'll have to address that. I'll see what the guys want to do, if they want to go back to stock or what. Got some oil coming down the back of the valley, going into the transmission inspection cover. Transmission, as I said before, has apparently been rebuilt by Jasper. Let's see what's going on. Quiet shifting, funny. Got some leaks coming up from above. And on 7.3s, could be turbo pedestal, could be a few things. But, I mean, in all actuality, everything seems to be fairly decent. I've seen them a lot worse. Here is your dipstick adapter, common 7.3 issue. The O-ring in that adapter starts leaking. We have several different options to fix that. We can see that the stock downpipe is still in place. I don't see a lot of soot around the uppipe connections to the exhaust manifolds. It's good. Looking up above, I don't see a lot of soot up at the collector flanges. Good. Everything seems to be intact as it should be. Once again, just like up above, we're looking at harnesses that are either damaged or have had somebody into them. You know, you never know what the last person might have done. All right, as we're coming along here, this is the supplemental fuel switching valve. This has an extra tank in the bed. Here's the valve for it. Not sure if it works yet or not, or what's going on. Haven't had that much time with it yet. Here's the factory valve for the dual tanks. Everything looks to be intact. Extra filter for that supplemental tank. As we're in here, you know, we're checking the carrier bearing, U-joints for excessive play. Looking at the frame, you know, any breaks, cracks, anything of the sort. A lot of the northern trucks with heavy rust, you know, have structural issues, especially in the spring perches. Everything looks to be fairly intact on this truck. I do like it when I see Ford tags in place. Talking about the speedometer bouncing before. This is that sensor in the rear diff. People know it by VSS sensor, vehicle speed sensor. I believe Ford technically calls it an ABS sensor. It has to do with the anti-lock brake system. So we'll have to dig into that and see if we have a loose connecting now. It just popped out. Looks like it's been taped up by somebody. It's got electrical tape all around it, so that could be our issue. Another thing we're going to do while we're in here is check the diff fluid. Let me grab a ratchet. And we have
The fact that it's over full, overflowing, and kind of has that milk chocolate look to it tells me right away there's been water introduced into there. Yeah, everything looks pretty good on this one. These rear spring perches are notoriously bad on the OBS trucks for collecting mud and debris up in here, starting to rust, going away. A lot of the northern guys know what I'm talking about. Switch is broken out of the bezel, common issue, along with, looks like somebody has glued the water and fuel wait to start lights. Looks like somebody's glued it from the backside. The bezel is broke. We'll address that issue once we get to it. It's going to be really tough because of the wood grain on this truck. Yeah, we can just throw a factory replacement bezel back in here, but it won't match what was in here. I'll have to see what the guys want to do on tackling this. Another thing on these trucks, column bushings on the shifter. If you have an excessive amount of play in the shifter, more than likely it's the bushings that are in the column that are wore out. This one seems to be fairly tight. We did have an issue earlier when I checked the hazards. They are working on the outside. They're flashing a little too fast in my opinion, so I'll have to check into the relay. But I'm sure the cluster bulbs are bad, so they're not flashing in here. They're not flashing on either of the turn signals either, so. We do know we had a AC issue, sure it needs charged, maybe a leak of some kind, we'll have to dig into that. We have all speeds though. The lights, these roll-along lights did not work, I'll have to dig in to see what's going on with that. This truck does have the factory dual visor set up, so. That one's broke. Along with that dual visor setup, generally comes with the auto dimming rearview mirror, which it's missing. I think it was in pieces. We took it out, the pieces out during the wash video. I've got those back at the other shop. It'd be nice to get that back in place so we have it. Not that it's super cool, but it was super cool for the day. Once we get in here, we'll detail everything. The CB now may stay, may go. It just depends on what the guys want to do with it. But we'll get this thing cleaned up. Now we're checking on just all the normal stuff. OBS trucks, common thing. They mounted the CB to the ashtray.
So now the ashtray slides are broken. Good job on that. There's probably a better spot to mount that CV than on an ashtray that's flimsy to begin with, so we'll have to just take care of that. Glove box seems to be in good shape. These center consoles, you know, common issues. Most of the time this top is broken, this one's all intact. Everything seems to be working. Who knows what we got going on in here with the steering wheel. Seems to be in fairly good shape. Leather wrapped, probably just leave that alone. Clean it up a little bit. Alright guys, we kind of walked through this inspection on this roll along here today. Our next video is probably going to be the window motor removal replacement on the rear doors. That seems to be a big issue with people. We're going to kind of walk you through it and show you the correct way. Take a look at some of the other issues that may be in that door while we're in there. We will be doing another video on the dash cluster and bezel, how to remove that bezel properly without breaking it, you know, some of the quick little fixes you can do on some of these things while you're in there. While we have the bezel out, we'll take a look at the cluster, take a look at all the light bulbs in the cluster, make sure everything's functioning properly in the cluster, clean all the dirt and dust out of it, you know, some of these simple little things you can do at home that don't take that long. If you guys have any suggestions,